B here, and welcome to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. When I say the word chemist, what comes to mind? Often there are a few different images that pop up when people picture a chemist. They see a mad scientist with smoking chemicals, a clueless scientist who blows up a lab, or a studious and serious scientist in a white lab coat carefully mixing chemicals. And while, yes, sometimes you have the clueless scientist making mistakes and the goofy ones with the smoking chemicals, there are thousands of scientists all over the world in white lab coats making cutting-edge discoveries every day. However, there is another important image of a scientist that we are going to learn more about through this course. You! A scientist is anyone who asks questions, gathers information, data, and evidence, and then shares their findings and knowledge with their community. Throughout this course, you will be doing just that. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define chemistry as a main branch of science and understand the different branches of chemistry. Understand the scientific process and how scientists use it to solve problems and answer questions. Atoms, the periodic table, water, and chemical reactions. These are all words that are usually associated with chemistry class. But what exactly is the field of chemistry? Chemistry is the study of matter, its properties, its behavior, how it is arranged, and how it changes. Matter is the stuff that everything is made of. It is anything that has mass and takes up space. Types of matter include solids, such as sugar, rocks, and wood, liquids, like water and orange juice, and even gases, like air and oxygen. You might not think that a gas has mass and volume, but picture an empty balloon and compare it to an inflated balloon. The air inside the inflated balloon definitely has volume and mass. While everything is made of matter, different kinds of matter have different characteristics. How these characteristics are analyzed and studied varies depending on the branch of chemistry. Biochemistry and organic chemistry focus on the matter that makes up living things and the processes that matter undergoes in those living things. Conversely, inorganic chemistry and physical chemistry focus on the matter that makes up salts, minerals, and the physical and chemical processes of reactions that are not associated with living things. Analytical chemistry focuses on studying matter in a quantitative way, analyzing numerical data as well as general observations. Finally, environmental chemistry looks at how chemical processes affect the environment. Chemistry, both as a whole and in these individual branches, is how we understand the matter that makes up everything in our universe, from the stars to the trees to even ourselves. But how do scientists actually gather this information and test new ideas? They rely on the scientific process. By now, somewhere in your studies, I am sure you have heard the term the scientific method. This is the process used by scientists to test ideas, acquire knowledge, and investigate phenomena. Traditionally, it includes a list of steps, including developing a hypothesis, testing a hypothesis, making observations, and gathering data. This is all still very much a part of the scientific method. However, scientists have started to move away from this set recipe approach and move toward a scientific design mindset. Scientists have kept the concept of testing new ideas, which is the heart of the traditional scientific method, and created more of a design approach that includes exploration and discovery, community analysis and feedback, and benefits and outcomes. This new way of looking at the scientific process is more holistic and in line with what scientists working in labs do on a daily basis. Let's spend a minute breaking down each of these aspects of the scientific process. At the core of the scientific process remains the concept of testing new ideas through exploration and discovery, which means gathering data, then interpreting it. Surrounding this is how we test these ideas through exploration and discovery. This includes asking questions, making observations, and gaining knowledge. It also includes community analysis and feedback, including peer review. And lastly, it includes considering the benefits and outcomes we get from these discoveries. In other words, asking how these new ideas can build knowledge and solve everyday problems is an important part of the process. Often in chemistry, the data collection, analysis, and interpretation is the most important aspect of the scientific process. When working on labs or writing scientific papers, it is often included in the discussion part of the report. Some questions you should ask yourself when analyzing and interpreting your data include, what were my results? What do my results tell me? How do my results differ from what I expected? What errors may have occurred during the experiment that could have affected my results? What improvements or changes would I make if I were to conduct the experiment again? And why do my results matter? As we went through the lesson today, we started to explore the wide field of chemistry. We defined matter, discussed the different branches of chemistry, and learned how scientists, including yourself, should approach a scientific problem. In our next lesson, we will review the metric system as we continue our introduction into chemistry. Until next time, remember that the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. Hey, hey.